there is a new aftermarket screen solution that can pass iOS 18's Repair Assistant without IC swap. This means a direct replacement of this aftermarket screen does not incur the display unknown part message. How does it work? Let's dig in and find out. Before iOS 18, replacing a third-party screen required first programming True Tone, then transferring the OEM screen Touch IC, along with the paired sensor Flex, in order to avoid the unknown part message. The motherboard paired the Touch IC, sensor Flex, and True Tone data. After iOS 18.3, the paired sensor Flex is not needed anymore. The motherboard checks only the Touch IC data and the True Tone data. Given this change, we speculate that this aftermarket screen resolves the pairing of the Touch IC and True Tone data. It passes Repair Assistant, but the service history reads used, same with the replacement of an OEM pulled screen. This could suggest that this third-party screen uses an OEM screen Touch IC, and the paired True Tone data has already been programmed. Based on these findings, we want to test a hypothesis. Could a third-party display, plus an OEM screen Touch IC, pass Repair Assistant, and remove the unknown part message? We are able to find an OEM pulled screen for iPhone 14 Pro. We'll program the True Tone data and transfer the OEM Touch IC to the aftermarket screen. Use a hot air gun to heat the IC evenly. Use a pry knife to flip up the IC. Apply flux to IC pads. Use the solder wick to remove the tens. Clean IC pads with PCB cleaner. Clean the adhesive residues. Place a solder stencil on the IC pads and spread the solder paste. Form the solder balls with a hot air gun at 280 degrees Celsius. Apply flux to the tag on flex cable pads. Use the solder wick to remove tens. Apply flux to the tag on flex cable pads. Solder the OEM Touch IC onto the tag on flex cable. Align the tag on flex solder pads with the screen solder pads. Apply flux to the solder pads. Use the soldering iron to melt solder wire onto the solder pads to create secure joints. Clean the solder pads with a PCB cleaner. Cover the solder pads with a piece of black tape. Repair Assistant recognizes the screen with the transferred IC and approves it. This means the motherboard only checks for the Touch IC data and True Tone, and the paired flex cable is no longer required. We also observe the same results on other models, including iPhone 13 to 15 full series. Besides from the tests we demonstrated in the video, we also discovered some exceptions. An OEM pulled screen locked to an ID cannot pass Repair Assistant. An OEM pulled screen with a replaced touch panel flex cable also fails Repair Assistant. Some aftermarket screen brands required programming True Tone before transferring the OEM Touch IC in order to successfully pass Repair Assistant. That's what we've covered so far. With iOS 18.3, Apple's part pairing restrictions have loosened, making screen replacements more flexible. With various screen options available in the market, finding screens that can pass Repair Assistant is crucial for repair and refurbishment businesses. Riva offers a wide range of replacement parts, including screens and batteries, that pass Repair Assistant. As part of our pre-sale service, we test and select screens to ensure 100% Repair Assistant verification for our customers. Stay tuned for the latest repair updates.